Colombian footballer Santiago Arias went down with a left ankle injury that looked to be one of the worst we've seen this year in the sport. Welcome back, everybody. I'm Dr. Brian Sutterer, and this is your number one source for learning about the unique medical side of the world of sports. In this video, I'm going to teach you guys a little bit about what happened here with Santiago Arias and his ankle injury just suffered in their recent match. As always, if you enjoy learning about this unique side of sports, please consider subscribing to my channel and be sure and go follow me over on Twitter for more real-time breakdowns and analysis. So here's the play where this happened. Keep an eye on his left leg and left ankle here. Basically, as he's sliding in to get the ball is really when everything goes wrong. He slides in here with that left leg, and everything in this position looks to be okay. There's nothing here that looks harmful or bad about this position. But if we continue the clip on, basically what happens is he gets his foot stuck underneath his body and kind of caught in the grass, and then just continues forward over on top of his foot, and ultimately, as we'll kind of talk about later on, is what causes his ankle injury. And then of course we can see as he comes up here, pretty substantial pain. His foot is externally rotated in relation to his lower leg. And the concern here is for, of course, an ankle dislocation, pretty much always associated with a fracture as well. This view kind of shows it a little bit better here with that position of his foot. So you can see how his foot is angled outward. That's external or external rotation in relation to his tibia or his lower leg. So typically the foot should be pointed upward here, but of course his is pointed out. And then unfortunately, as he continues to kind of roll over here, you can see that there's a pretty clear deformity that we can see down in that ankle, signifying where he's had that injury. This is an anatomy model of our right foot and ankle. And we've got the bones here and all the different ligaments that help provide some support to those joints shown. The specific joint that's dislocated here with an ankle dislocation is most often the tibio-talar joint, or the joint between the tibia, which is the big shin bone, and the talus, which is the bone that kind of sits down here just below the tibia. What I've done now here is I've hidden everything else to show you just the talus, the tibia, the fibula, and then some of those ligaments that help provide support there. Whenever we see an ankle dislocation, it's this joint right here that's basically come out of place, and it's oftentimes associated with a fracture just because of how tightly constructed that joint is to begin with. If we go back to the clip here of when this happened, basically what we're looking at is most likely this kind of ridge that we can see is part of that tibia, and then the talus is just down below it where the foot's been dislocated. Here's another ankle model, and we're just kind of looking head on at this, but this is gonna be the tibia in the front, and then of course the talus is gonna be this bone kind of down deep inside. The joint has a lot of mobility for our foot pointing up and pointing down, but it doesn't have much mobility going side to side, and that's because of the structure of this joint space. The talus is like my fist here, and then between the tibia and the fibula, they sort of come down on either side to firmly secure that talus in place. This means you can slide the talus back and forth pretty well, but it's hard to rotate it from side to side or spin it. But whenever the foot gets excessively externally rotated, like what happened here with Arias, that can cause that space to widen so much that you tear these ligaments and can dislocate your ankle and cause a fracture. The classic high ankle sprain ligament is the AITFL ligament, and it sits between the fibula and the tibia, basically keeping those two bones firmly attached, covering the talus. So when you externally rotate the foot, you're pointing it outward this way. And what that does is it causes this space between the tibia and the fibula to widen, which can injure that high ankle sprain ligament, ultimately tear it, cause it to fail, and then this joint can completely dislocate. If we look at this play again from another view here, keep an eye again, it's his left ankle here. And as he slides, everything looks okay. He gets an excessive amount of what we call dorsiflexion here between the foot and the ankle. But then right at the end, as he falls on his ankle, that flips it into that extreme external rotation, which is gonna cause the injury. Looking from behind again, he comes in and slides, everything's okay, everything looks okay. But then right at this transition point, he falls, that foot externally rotates, causes the injury to the ankle. A couple other things to point out here. Initially when I saw this, I wondered if this white could have been the bone. Of course, if the bone comes through the skin on a fracture, that's called an open fracture and could be a lot more serious because of infection risk. But I think actually looking at it in more detail, I think it's just his sock, because you can see on his other foot, he's got a similar kind of white mark there. So I haven't seen official reports as if he had an open fracture, but certainly it's going to be a more concerning injury if he did. And the on-field management of something like this is, of course, going to be extremely important, and a lot of it is focused on stability to maintain blood flow to the tissues around the foot. The reporting is that they were able to reduce or basically put the joint back in proper alignment on the field, and the picture you've seen circulating around online comes up every time someone's had an injury like this, but I don't think is actually his. What I've done now is I've brought in all the different arteries that we have around the ankle and the foot. And the big reason you want to get that joint back in place is because when it's dislocated, you can cause injury or pinching to these blood vessels, which can damage the blood supply to the foot and cause worse injury. The yellow I've added are now all the nerves, and so you can see there's even more important structures here around this joint that can become damaged, stretched, torn whenever you have an injury like this. So you want to get the joint back in proper position as quickly as possible. There is a very brief moment here when the medical team is taking him off the pitch where you can see somebody is basically holding his ankle joint to stabilize that joint. His joint here looks to be in a proper position. So this tells me that they were likely able to reduce his joint on field, which is a great sign. I am surprised they don't have something more of a splint or a vacuum cast or something around the joint here, because just having someone's hand isn't the most stable, best way to do this, but they might have just not had the equipment that they needed. There's really nothing else we can tell from this here. You can see, you know, they're carrying him off. Again, the ankle joint here looks to be in good proper alignment, so that's reassuring, but certainly the evaluation is going to be key to look and see what fracture is present, how much damage there is to the ligaments, and anything like blood vessels, nerves. Definitely a major injury, something that's going to be really tough to come back from. Guys can still come back from this, but you've got a lot of different structures that can be damaged here that you've got to take a close look at. So that's it for the video, everybody. Thank you as always for watching. Let me know any questions or comments down below. And until next time, we'll see you later. Bye.